It's Black Friday, and the billing system is down. Everything you've worked for, it's all going up in smoke because the business is shut down at this point, right when you least can afford it. You've been hacked. That's the simple fact. Now, do you know who did it? Do you know what was taken? Do you know if they're still in your system? Do you know where they came from? Ultimately, can you stop the bleeding? Well, a solution called Extended Detection and Response, or XDR for short, is something that could help with this. What is XDR and how does it work? That's what I'm going to cover in this video. First of all, definition. It depends on who you ask. So for instance, if you were to ask IDC, they would tell you that it involves gathering security telemetry, security information, running it through an analytics engine, which then produces a detection of malicious activities, and then ultimately a response to those activities. Forrester adds to that definition and says it's an evolution of EDR. EDR is endpoint detection and response. That's a capability that would be on laptops, desktops, and systems like that to block security events. They also add to the definition threat hunting and the notion of investigation. So proactively looking for problems and then reactively responding to them. And then Gartner adds to the definition further still and says it's a cloud-based platform and that it reduces security tool sprawl, that it also reduces alert fatigue and ultimately reduces operational cost. So that's great. Now, how do we make a system do all of those things? What does an XDR system actually look like? Well, it turns out it could look like this. So we have lots of different types of systems. Like we have an endpoint system, an EDR that can talk to those. Remember I mentioned that earlier. An EDR would talk to all of my desktops, laptops, and things like that, gather information from them, and report on that. Now what else could I have in this system? Well, I've got a network, so I could have a network detection and response system. An NDR, you might have guessed. NDR is looking at the view of security from the network perspective. Then we could have something that we call a Security Information and Event Management System, a SIM. And a SIM could gather information from sources such as a database, an application, other security appliances and security components. In fact, a SIM could also gather information from an EDR and an NDR. But in this example, we'll leave them all as separate peer systems, just for the purpose of this exercise. And then also, we might take threat-related information. That is a feed that comes into us from a number of different sources, potentially, telling us what's happening in the security world right now. What exploits are being used more actively these days than other days? Then what I'd like to do is take all of that information and put it up into a higher level system. This is the XDR. So I'm going to take the information from my EDR, from my NDR, from my SIM, the threat intelligence feed, and put all of those things up here into the XDR, which has a number of different components to it. One is it's going to correlate. It's going to take information across all of these systems and correlate them and try to give you a single view of this rather than lots of different views. It's going to also add to this the ability to analyze information. So we might use artificial intelligence to increase our ability to understand what the underlying cause of the threat is. We might also add to this a system called a UBA, a user behavior analytics capability that looks for abnormal activities that certain users are doing that doesn't match with their peer groups, as an example. We could also do add to the system the ability to investigate. So that's a reactive thing. We've just been hacked. We're going to go out and see who's doing this and what's the extent of the damage. That's the investigate part. How about threat hunting? I mentioned that earlier. This is the more proactive version of that. It's going out and seeing what might be happening in my environment. I don't have any indicators, no alarm bells have gone off, but I wonder if somebody is doing this or that. I formulate a hypothesis and I do an investigation proactively. That could be in this platform as well. And then ultimately, response. This is where we bring in the notion of a SOAR, a security orchestration, automation, and response capability that allows us to manage cases, allows us to figure out who's doing what to whom, And what actions do I need to take ultimately to stop the bleeding, to figure out what I need to do to get us back up and operational? We would use things like a dynamic playbook in order to guide the security analyst's activities through all of this process. Now, these systems might also add in a few other things, depending on your definition here as well. We might add something called attack surface management and have that feed into the system. We could also use things like vulnerability management, things that look for scans in our network and tell us, okay, it looks like you're vulnerable here. This is an area that's a soft underbelly that you need to look at. All of this ultimately is designed to create for a security analyst up here a single pane of glass, a single place where I can go and manage all of this. And if we do it well, it becomes a single pane of glass. If we do it poorly, it becomes a single glass of pane. We want to do this right. Do an XDR the right way, and you'll be able to stay out in front of the attack. Hopefully avoid the hack scenario that I talked about at the beginning of the video, and be able to investigate whenever an attack does occur.